the storage in seeds. So as I told you that there are two types of seeds, monocotyledonous and dicotyledonous seeds, and the food storage in seeds, food is stored either in the cotyledon or in the special tissue which is known as the endosperm. In seeds like gram, pea, bean and mustard, the food is stored in the cotyledon. In some parts, the food is stored in cotyledon. Cotyledon, which is also known as seed leaf, so that in that case in which food is stored in cotyledon and there is no endosperm present in the seed, such seeds are known as non-endospermic or ex-albuminous seed. Okay, so in those seeds in which the food is stored in the cotyledon part of the seed, that seeds are known as non-endospermic or ex-albuminous seed because endosperm is completely absent in these seeds, that in case of gram, pea, etc. And then the second category is in which the food is stored in the endosperm of the seed. Some seeds like castor, maize, etc. In that case, the food is stored in the endosperm part of the seed. So that seeds are known as endospermic or albuminous seeds. Albuminous seed. So on the basis of storage of food, the seed are of two types, non-endospermic or ex-albuminous, in which the food is stored in cotyledon, and the second one is endospermic or albuminous, in which the food is stored in endosperm. So that is about storage in seeds. Now the second topic is structure of dicotyledonous seed. So we will going to discuss about structure of seeds. I told you that there are two types of seeds, monocotyledon and dicotyledon. So we have to discuss the structure of both. So first of all, the structure of dicotyledonous. Seeds. What is the structure of dicotyledon? So the bean seed, which is kidney shaped, bean is the grain, that bean seed which is kidney shaped and it is covered by a hard seed coat, that is the important part for all the seed, and the seed coat contains two layers. The seed coat is the first part. And that seed coat contains two important layers, that are testum and the second one is tegmen. So testa and tegmen, testa is the outer layer and tegmen is the inner layer, and both these layers are fused together and provide protection to the embryo. After that, on the concave side of the seed, there is a whitish oval scar which is called hilum. The second part is hilum, which is a whitish oval scar present in the concave side of the seed. It is the point at which the seed was attached to the pod with the help of follicle, which you have discussed earlier also. And close to that hilum, at the one end point, there is a small opening, and that small opening is known as micropyle. There is a small opening which is known as microbial, and this microbial helps to absorb water during germination. Germination, we will discuss this later on, and this part helps to absorb water during germination and also serve as a passage for diffusion of respiratory gases. That means exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide occurs with the help of this microbial only. And at the other end of hilum, this is present at one end, and at the other end of hilum, there is elongated ridge in parts are present at the edge of the anum at the one end, microphyll, and at the other end, bran. After it, when the seed coat is peeled off, if you remove the seed coat from the seed, then the white fleshy body is seen. That white fleshy body consists of two parts. First, two fleshy cotyledons, the cotyledons which help in the storage of food, and the second part is a short axis to which cotyledons remain attached to the seed. The axis consists of two parts, also radicle which lies outside the cotyledon and give rise to the root system, which I told you earlier also. And the second one is plumule, which is protected by two cotyledons, and it is present below the point of attachment. Monocotyledonous seed. So what is the structure of monocotyledonous seed? Maize is a one-seeded root. Maize is the seed which is one-seeded, and it is called carposis, in which the fruit wall is fused with the seed coat. And the maize seed is a flat shaped structure, almost triangular oblong structure, and it shows a large yellowish area which marks the position of endosperm in the cell. And on the lower side there is a whitish area which contains the embryo. The seed coat in this cell is not distinct, as it is fused with the fruit wall itself, and the microphyll and ilum are also not distinguishable. So all these structures which are present in the dicotyledonous cell, which were seed coat, microphyll, ilum, all these are not present in this cell because they are not distinguished properly. The internal structure of grain can be studied in a longitudinal section. It is the most important structure. It shows two distinct regions. The first one is upper large region, which is known as endosperm, and the lower small region, which is known as embryo. Endosperm is surrounded by special one layer thick cell called eleuron layer, and it is filled with eleuron grains which are proteinaceous in nature. And the embryo consists of single cotyledon, the plumule and the radicle. Plumule and radicle, plumule goes into the shoot part, radicle goes into the root part, and the sheath shaped cotyledon is also present, which is known as scotyledon. After that, flax structure is pressed against the endosperm, and scotyledon does not contain food, and its function is to absorb the food. And after that, all other parts, which are plumule, radicle, polypen, all these are same as in the all other structures of the seed. So student, that is all about storage in food, in seeds, storage of food in seeds, and then the structure of monocotyledonous seeds and the structure of dicotyledonous seeds. So students, that's all for today. Thank you.